Starting in 3ds Max 2018, you will discover a rather important change to the rendering engines. MentorRay, a well-established fixture of 3ds Max for many years, has been replaced by the new kid on the block. Arnold, the rendering engine that's been the go-to solution in movie productions, is now available in 3ds Max. When you install 3ds Max 2018, you automatically get a free license of the Arnold Renderer from Solid Angle, the developers of Arnold. This free license for MAXtoA, as it's called, in reference to the MAXtoArnold plugin, is good for front-end rendering. This means it is set for single machine rendering through the GUI. You'll need additional commercial licenses for background renderings and render farms. Plugin updates and other goodies such as scene converter scripts and sample files are available on the Solid Angle Arnold Downloads page. This multi-part tutorial will guide you in your first steps experimenting with Arnold. The integration to the 3ds Max UI is effortless, which means you set up the rendering engine much like any other using the Render Setup dialog. Some tabs change, and some remain the same. The Arnold Renderer tab gives you access to render settings, which we will explore later. But what happens to legacy scenes and projects? What happens to scenes saved in other rendering engines, or that use legacy or specific types of materials, maps, and lights? Let's explore this together. The scene you will be using is simple, yet useful for the purposes of this tutorial. It shows a dining set with a table, four chairs, and a few additional props. When opened in 3ds Max 2017, note that it uses MentorRay as a rendering engine. It is also using legacy standard materials for the most part, but also one or two materials based on MentorRay's Arc and Design material. There are also six photometric lights illuminating the scene. To download this file, a download link is available in the description section of this movie. Open this scene in 3ds Max 2018. The first indication that something has fundamentally changed is the obsolete file warning, prompting you to resave the file to a new format. Click OK to dismiss the warning, and another warning appears. This one warns you that since the file contains MentorRay legacy assets, something needs to be done to make them compatible with 3ds Max 2018. If you click OK, any missing legacy assets will be removed. You also have the option to open the scene converter to make additional adjustments. Click OK for now. The scene loads in 3ds Max 2018 without any further problems. If you were to check the material editor, you'll note that the Arc and Design material has been automatically converted to a physical material. This is good news, as the physical material is easily the go-to material in 3ds Max moving forward. It's powerful, easy to use, and compatible with most rendering engines, including Arnold. Still, because we haven't manually run any conversions, the scene loads using the scanline renderer by default. In a way, it is still using some legacy features, such as the standard material. Even though some legacy features work or can be made to work with Arnold, it is better to help the process a little bit. Close all dialog boxes. Typically, with older scenes, you want to use Scene Converter to update them to better and more modern standards. Go to the Scene Converter dialog, accessible from the rendering menu. By default, the Art preset is chosen. This is significant, because although other Arnold presets and scripts are made available by Solid Angle, the Art preset may well be the only thing you need. If you expand the conversion rules, you will see that this preset gives you all you need to ensure 100% compatibility. Materials will be converted to physical materials, lights converted to photometric lights, which are fully compatible with Arnold, MR Sun and Sky converted to Sun Positioner, which again is compatible with Arnold. Even cameras and exposure control are set to give you optimum results when converted. Basically, the only option you might want to change here is in the Editor tab, whereas you ask for the renderer to be switched to Arnold instead of Art. As you convert the scene, you're effectively making it Arnold ready. If you so choose, you can even save the preset changes under a new name, such as My Arnold, dismiss scene converter when done. The materials may disappear from the viewport, but you can bring them back using Views, Show Materials in Viewport As, Shaded Materials with Maps. Select the camera in the scene. You will find it is indeed a physical camera now, and you can therefore set it to use exposure control in the Modify panel. This ought to make the camera viewport shading a bit better. Check the Render Settings dialog to confirm that Arnold is indeed the chosen rendering engine. Check the Material Editor to see that all standard materials have been converted to physical materials. Interestingly, you do get a red warning about a noise map being not supported. You can, in fact, still use some of those old 3ds Max maps types in Arnold. All you need is to go to the Systems tab in the Render Settings dialog and enable the Legacy 3ds Max Support option. This should take care of the Arnold warning, and you can dismiss that dialog. Render the camera view to get a feel for the scene. It renders okay, but could use a bit of fine-tuning. Even though the materials were converted to physical materials, they are still based on old and obsolete material definitions. For example, the plates and utensils rely on bitmaps to convey reflections. This is hardly accurate and should be addressed. Using the material editor, sample the material applied to the utensils. Delete the bitmap associated with the material, you won't need it anymore. As for the material itself, one of the perks of using physical materials is that you can choose material properties from a list of presets. In this case, I will use the silver preset from the metals group. For the plates, I will choose a glazed ceramic preset, while perhaps giving the base color a touch of beige. By duplicating the last render and comparing it to a new one, you can already see the differences these small changes introduced. You can continue experimenting with this, for example, setting the wine glasses to a Saturn silver preset while retaining the old bitmap in the color and bump channels. The wine bottles could use some help, mostly for the glass part. They have similar material definitions. The white wine bottle has green glass, so you can use a solid glass preset for it. Just make the transparency color a mid to light green. The same applies for the red wine bottle, with a slightly darker red to reduce transparency. Finally, you can fine-tune the wood and metal textures on the table and chairs by sampling the material from one of the chairs. Give the wood a coat of varnish, and set the metal to a polished aluminum finish. Just make sure the base color is very dark, almost black. Compare your last render to the original, and you'll notice a significant improvement that comes strictly from physical material adjustments. As you can see, the physical material is 100% compatible with Arnold, it is easy to use, and you're probably already familiar with it. If you prefer, you can use Arnold-specific materials and shaders, and there are many. If you right-click in the Material Editor, you'll note a full Arnold category under Materials. That is in turn subdivided into more options as you delve deeper into what Arnold has to offer. The same is true under the Maps category, where you'll see quite a few additions there as well. If this starts to get confusing, you can indeed stick with the physical material workflow, and that in itself will take you a long way. This said, if you want to experiment with Arnold-specific materials and shaders, then a good place to start would be the standard surface material. This Arnold material is the closest you get to Max's physical material. The parameter groups are roughly the same, with options for clear coat, base color, reflections, transparency, here called transmission, subsurface scattering, etc. There are no clear-cut benefits to choose between 3ds Max's physical material and Arnold's standard surface material, except maybe the available presets that are part of the physical material. With the materials now in place, we'll look at lighting next. At this time, the scene is lit by 6 photometric lights that are fully compatible with Arnold. Indeed, you can keep on using photometric lights in your future projects, or you can elect to use Arnold lights to light a scene. This requires a bit of workflow rethinking, but you might find it worth your while. This is what we'll explore in the next movie.